In times of war, sacrifices are necessary. In times of saving Thetis, there is no sacrifice too heavy to make. Liliana has taken this to heart. She is the will that keeps us all aware, safe, and alive from unseen threats. I agree with killing our enemies, but when you see enemies everywhere, then killing our enemies takes on an entire new meaning. Liliana is indispensable. We would not have gotten where we are without her and without her spies. Whereas Cullen leads the general army, Cassandra has been with me to protect me as I travel, Thetis. Josephine has dealt with all groups, nobles, royalty, and enemies diplomatically. These four form the core of the Inquisition. I suppose that the apex of the hierarchy is me, the Inquisitor. The people below me make sacrifices so our mission can succeed. I'm just glad that I don't have to do what they do.
What you've become. The righteous stand before the darkness, and the Maker shall guide them.
Liliana.
I understand you have spared the Grey Wardens from destroying what goodwill was left them. 'Tis good of you, considering the weakness Corypheus exploited was their own doing. Still, should a true archdemon one day arise, they will no doubt be needed. Or so they would have us believe.
Now that you've seen the Inquisition up close, what are your impressions?
'Tis remarkable what you have built. I will give you that. A web of favors has wrapped every noble family in southern Thedas around your fingers. All this in precious little time, conjured from thin air through the power of fervor alone. I wonder if Corypheus suspected what he was enabling, just as I wonder what will become of all this once he is defeated.
Whatever happens, the Inquisition will survive.
That alone is worthy of wonder. A new player on the stage, a figure of might and marvel. Beware the heights you reach, Inquisitor. When this is done, many will be eager to knock you back down.
That's not a very happy thought now, is it?
I'd like to know more about you.
Ah, yes. Whence comes the mystery woman slinking her way into the Inquisition's ranks? Once I was an apostate, living well away from the banal influence of the Chantry in the Kakari Wilds. Then came the Fifth Blight with its darkspawn, and I left Ferelden for the Empress's court. 'Tis certain the nobles of Orlais breathe a collective sigh of relief that I am now here.
You were in Ferelden during the Blight?
The Blight began in the Kakari Wilds, so yes, I experienced it firsthand. Indeed, I fought at the hero of Ferelden's side for a time. He is the reason the Blight was defeated. In the end, what he did for me, I will always be grateful. And after that, I came to Orlais, the last place one would look for me, or such was my hope.
The Orlesian court seems like an odd place to find someone like you.
That was the point, originally. I knew the Empress was intrigued by the arcane, and that I could answer questions no Chantry mage could. Thus, we fit together nicely. I became her advisor, and she my benefactor and source of refuge. Truth be told, our arrangement would not have lasted much longer. Too many wagging tongues, even for Selene.
It's odd that an apostate could live so openly.
It confuses those who expect apostates to cower and hide. I stand boldly before them and demand to know why I need some Chantry mage to teach me to control my power. They would put me on a leash so they can feel safer at night. I am uninterested in their comfort. Naturally, it helps to have friends in high places.
Tell me more about your son.
He is a very special young man.
Special in what way?
In every way. At first, Kieran was a means to an end. But as he grew, I never thought of myself as a mother, Inquisitor. I had no good example to follow. I find myself becoming something I can barely recognize.
You're not the only one.
I'll leave you to the garden.
Of course.
Of somewhat fallen fortune. Josephine attempted to reinstate her family as a trading power in Orlais, which triggered an assassination contract taken out more than 100 years ago by a family known as the Duperriquets. Despite the contract's age and the fact that the Duperriquets are no longer nobility, the contract is still binding. A group of assassins honoring the contract, called the House of Repose, won't rest until Josephine is dead. Go to the Marquise's party.
Thank you for seeing me in private, Minister Bellise.
I chastise you for taking me from the party, Inquisitor, but the Marquis throws such dull affairs, it's hardly worth it. I assume you wish to discuss your petition to elevate these Duperriquets to a minor lordship. Tell me, why should I allow you to pollute the Orlesian nobility any further than it's already been muddled?
Surely even a minister could do worse than have the Inquisition in her debt.
I am a well-positioned woman. I require something more concrete than vague promises of future gifts. And do not attempt to charm me. I am far too old to tolerate it. What can you possibly provide that will make your petition worth my effort?
There's a lot of things that we can do.
Information. Unless you believe your source is better than agents of the Inquisition.
Normally, I wouldn't trust your discretion. But the left hand of the Divine is working for you, is she not? Sister Leliana is a resourceful woman. I could certainly make use of her talents. Very well, Inquisitor. Should you fulfill this bargain, I shall raise the Duperriquets into lordship.
Well, that went easier than I thought it would. Let's go talk to Josephine now.
Please tell Lord Dorian that I can't get him an invitation to the Winterson Ball in Leeds.
He won't be surprised. He said it would probably be beyond you.
It's not beyond me, it's tell him I'll try.
I must return to Valrayo to see that everything is in order. Please join me when you can.
Anytime, but I just came from just past Valrayo. Let's head out then. This is a little bit important, so our diplomat needs to be taken off the kill list. I need to make sure I have this in mind. Let's see the greater map of, yes, over this way. Babro has is looking nice. Cleaner. The spirits are lifted compared to what happened when I first came here. Some writing on the wall. Okay. Josephine.
I received a letter from the House of Repose, Your Worship. They acknowledge their contract is null and void. There is no longer a price on my life.
I'm glad you don't have to live your life looking over your shoulder anymore.
I regret we were forced to deal with them. That you are endangered by my part in the game. Did I ever mention I used to be a bard?
You were a singer.
Bards entertain the Orlesian court. They sing, play music, make charming conversation, and spy. Many young nobles put on a mask and practice playing the game in such a fashion.
What made you interested in becoming a bard?
I was attending a university in Valroyo when I learned about bards. There was such an air of romance about them. Stories of secrets, trysts, and fascinating people. A group of us, young gentry from Antiva, decided this exciting life was for us.
How did you go from being a wandering singer to an ambassador?
In a very sad fashion. During one particular intrigue, I encountered a bard sent to kill my patron. We fought. Or perhaps scrapped is the better word. Both of us terrified. We were at the top of a steep flight of stairs. The other bard threw a knife, and I pushed him away from me. You can imagine the result.
You were only defending yourself.
But it was such a waste, Inquisitor. When I took off his mask, I knew him. We'd attended parties together. If I'd stopped to reason, if I'd used my voice instead of scuffling like a common thug, I'll always wonder who that young man would have grown into.
He seemed willing enough to murder you for the game.
Perhaps. I feel I'm the last to judge whether or not he would have actually used the blade. In all the commotion, forgive me, I don't believe I ever thanked you for helping me with this.
Your skills truly benefit the Inquisition. We wouldn't want to lose you.
Well, House Montiliyet will always be grateful to you. And should you ever visit Antiva, stories of the welcome we'll give you will be told for years.
I just might do that someday, actually. All right. Can we leave Orlais? I've never really felt comfortable coming to Valroyo. Don't really know. Probably because it's just the heart of Shemdom. The heart of the Shemlings. Well, I can't go out to the Forbidden Oasis. I am aware that there is a dragon, though. Is it the Stormcoast? Crestwood? That's, there may also be one in Crestwood. But I know that there's one in Stormcoast. So while Cullen is still busy, because we need to track down Samson, I think the dragon is over here. I'm not sure how we got out there. I think I'll take this camp and I'll head over to here, and then I think there was a boat that took us over. We'll try that again. This is their one of their main mining places for red lyrium that they used to have.
Dispatch for you.
I don't have time.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Shemin. Let's go. I need to mark on my map to go through the tunnel there. You won't be able to follow us. It's raining here. And now the Inquisition owns this place. What is this over here? Red Templars. Next. It's a good thing we came when we did.
Sarah.
Carry on. The rain still comes through into this place. Alright, I need to find the boat that we took to the island before. There was a very powerful dragon over there. Was it here? Red Templar key. I don't think it was these boats, though. Black Lotus. I think it was further in. See why our guards are not inside. You don't want to be anywhere near this red lyrium. I've had enough exposure to it as it is. I hope it's not doing anything to me. There's a hole in the wall here. It's been some months since I've been here, so I don't remember exactly how it goes. I just know we need to get out to the dock. I think we're close by it. Is it down? They could always strike back and start mining this stuff again. This is not what I remember. Stay away from the red stuff. Damp everywhere in here. Out of the way, Sarah. I don't know where it is. In here. We'll have to keep searching until we find it then. Found it. It's through a hole in the wall on the upper floor where we were. Let's go find this dragon, shall we?
Oh, sure. But, oh, I bet there's nothing.
There's a dragon here. I don't know if it breathes fire or ice, but there's a dragon here. Or electricity. First saw it on the beach across this water on land. Elf root. Can't say no to that. No, dragonling. Slippery rocks. That's what happens when they get wet for thousands of years.
Down you go.
There was a dragon that we fought where dragonlings, it's little younglings kept on coming in to fight us. It's maybe the case here. This one has many little dragonlings. Slippery. Slippery rocks. Sun and rain. Fun. There it is. It's not as small of an island as I originally thought. It's fair size. Here, this one is huge. Let's take it down. Feel this. And this. Sarah, we have to be apart. It's an electricity dragon as well. Not sure how effective my electrical attacks will be. Sarah, stay apart from it. I need to be closer. Want to be. I need to be. No, my electrical attacks seem to have no effect. My staff is wreaking havoc on his side, though. Again, Sarah. Barrier up. Too far. Yeah. right into its head. Out of the way, sir. It's the end of that dragon. Armor, that's... it's well crafted, it's just not as nice as I would have. I don't think it's going to protect as well as I would like it to. A master dragon slaying rune. Schematic. Interesting. And of course all the dragon parts. I think all of it. Did it have anything other than... well, there were dragonlings on the island, so they have to come from this mum. Prophet's Laurel. Serpent Stone. More Prophet's Laurel. It's a rare herb. I should see about getting more potent herb potions for the Inquisition. We don't have a chief alchemist. Not since Haven. Well, that about do it. Time to turn to Skyhold and see what we can do about Samson and the rest of the missions that are available on the war table.